Hello friends, welcome to radio frequency classes. This is another part of the problem solving based on the transmission line theory classes. In this, I'll be taking a lossless transmission line. For that, length will be given and two parameter, the inductance and capacitance per unit length will be given. And at what frequency signal is transmitted across the transmission line will be given. And we have to find out the electrical length of the line in the transmission line. So as you can see here, in air lossless transmission line of length 50 centimeter with inductance 10 microhenry per meter and capacitance of 40 pico farad per meter is operated at 25 megahertz is given, and we have to find out the electrical length. So we know the formula of the electrical length, that is nothing but beta is equal to electrical length is beta into L. Beta is 2 pi by lambda, okay, and the physical length of the transmission line. So here only one parameter is missing, which is wavelength of the signal in the transmission line. So formula is very simple. Why I have taken here C dash, because already C I have denoted for the capacitance. So lambda will be C dash by F. Frequency is given to us 25 megahertz, and C is nothing but the phase velocity Vp. And as the question says, in question it's given lossless transmission line. So when it is a lossless transmission line, Vp will be nothing but 1 over root of L C. So L and C value is given. So from here we can easily find out the value of the phase velocity, and from the phase velocity, keeping here knowing the frequency, we can find out the wavelength. So L and C value is given, you can calculate the phase velocity, you will get it as a 0.5 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So you can calculate this 0.5 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So this value you can keep it here, and frequency is given, you can find out the wavelength. Okay, so wavelength will be nothing but 2 meter. So that will be 2 pi length of the transmission line, which is nothing but 50 centimeter 0.5 meter. So here 2 and 2 will be cancelled out, and pi into L. L is 0.5, so it will be nothing but pi by 2 or 0.5 into pi. So electrical length will be pi by 2 radian. So this way we can solve the question based on the electrical length. These things are not given. We can take directly this C dash as speed of light, which is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So for lossless transmission line, when inductance and capacitance, these values are given, we should find out the phase velocity, and then correspondingly we can find out the wavelength. Another question is, in a twin wire transmission line in air, the adjacent voltage maxima are at 12.5 centimeter and 27.5 centimeter. Find out the operating frequency. So this question is related with the VSWR and the standing wave in a given transmission line. So that wave actually given in such a way, three phase, or in a transmission line, if you'll see, the wave forms something like this standing wave. So by seeing these two picture, it is very clear that maxima between two, if I'll say this is a first one and this is second one, this is lambda by 2, because the total length is given as lambda, okay, also it is given as 0 pi. So 0 to 2 pi change correspond to one wavelength. So total distance is 1 lambda. So distance between the two maxima or distance between two minima, both are lambda by 2. Same way, in a standing wave also, the distance between two adjacent minima is given as lambda by 2, or distance between two adjacent maxima is also given by lambda by 2. So from here, lambda by 2 is equal to distance, if I'll say, okay, there two maxima is given, okay, one is 27.5 and another one is 12.5, and here to find C, and this lambda by 2 is nothing but D2 minus D1, and D2 is 27.5 and D1 is 12.5 centimeter. So from here, lambda will be 2 times of 27.5 minus 12.5 centimeter, which is nothing but 30. So from here, we know the formula C is equal to F lambda, okay, our frequency is equal to C by lambda, so 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second divided by 30 centimeter, we will get as 1 into 10 to the power 9, which is nothing but C for this problem is 1 gigahertz. So if two values are given and it is given that it is maxima, okay, or it is for corresponding minimas, we can find out the operating frequency. The question can be asked in a different way also. It can be asked as a first maxima, then adjacent minima. Then we should equate this difference with lambda by 4 and we can solve the question. So here I am going to give a simple question, and kindly solve this question and answer in the comment box. If open circuit impedance is 100 ohm and short circuit impedance is given as 25 ohm, this is nothing but the input impedance for a transmission line. If transmission line is having open circuit impedance as 100 ohm and this transmission line is having the input impedance in case of short circuit as 25 ohm, what would be the characteristic impedance of this transmission line? Okay, we have a transmission line object, not characteristic impedance, which is having open circuit impedance of 100 ohm and short circuit impedance of 25 ohm input impedance. Okay, so what would be the characteristic impedance? Kindly solve and comment in the video. This is third question. In this, a short circuited stub is sun connected with a transmission line as shown in figure. If Z0 is 50 ohm, find out the impedance at the junction. So here we are having a transmission line. So we should divide in three sections. What question says is, we have a short circuited transmission line section which is connected with in parallel with this transmission line, and this transmission line is terminated with 100 ohm load impedance, and here it is short circuit. It means ZL is nothing but 0 ohm. Once it is short circuited, easily we can realize if it is open, we should take ZL as infinity, and when it is short circuit, we should take it as a 0 ohm. Length of these two section is given. For this section, length is lambda by 2, and for this short circuited section, length is lambda by 8. Our task is to find out the admittance at this junction. Means we have to find out the impedance here for this section and impedance for this section. And parallel of these two will be the impedance here, and then 1 by that impedance will give you the admittance. This is the solution and concept of this question. How to solve? We know the input impedance equation. Zin is equal to Z0, ZL plus J, Z0 10, beta L divided by Z0, J, ZL 10, beta L. So here if I will say this is the first one and this section is the second one, I will take two sections and I will try to find out the impedance at both the for both the section, and then I will take the parallel combination of this, that will be the impedance at this junction. Okay, so first I will find Z in 1 for the first section. Length is lambda by 8, L is given as lambda by 8 for this section, Z naught is we can take it as a 50 ohm. Okay, if it is not given, then 15. But in question itself, you can see I have given here Z naught as 50 ohm. So we should take it as 50 ohm. And ZL for this one is 0 because it is short circuited. Okay, so input impedance will be written as Z in equals to 50 into 0 plus J 50. 10 beta L is 10 2 pi by lambda into lambda by 8. So cancel 2 pi by 4 is nothing but 1 divided by Z naught is 50 plus J ZL is 0. So this Z in will be 50 and 50 cancelled out, J 50, 10 pi by 4 is 1. So we will get as J 50. So first impedance is J in is equals to J 50. For this section, we got the impedance as J 50 ohm. For the second section, which is lambda by 2, the input impedance is nothing but ZL itself. Okay, you can take this formula, keep here lambda by 2 in place of length, L is equals to lambda by 2, and find out the input impedance. That will be nothing but Zin will be equals to ZL. So in second case, Zin 2 will be equals to 100 ohm. Okay, and Zin 1 came to be J 50 ohm. So parallel of these two will be the Z at the junction. So parallel of these two will be Z will be Z in 1 parallel Z in 2, which is J 50 into 100 divided by J 50 plus 100. So we can solve it J 5000 divided by J 50 plus 100. So what we can do is J 5000 divided by J 50 plus. Okay, so this came to be as a J 5000 divided by J 50 plus 100. So admittance will be 1 by Z. So we can write it as a J 50 into J 50 plus 100 divided by J 5000. So we can multiply with minus J 5000 minus J 5000. So this will be nothing but 25 minus J 50 divided by 2500. So this we can solve. We will get as a 0.01 minus 0.02 J inverse. So this will be the admittance Y is 0.01 minus 0.02 J. So this is the process to find the admittance at any junction, whether it is in series or shunt case. Here I have taken a shunt case and I have derived the value of Y at this junction. So process was, if you know the length of the sections, use the input impedance formula, okay, corresponding to the given length, and find out the impedance. Take the parallel combination of this, convert just opposite of that, that will be admittance. If you like the content, kindly subscribe my channel. Thank you so much. So this kind of video I will be bringing for the different parts, like short circuit and open circuit. And if you need any video related to the transmission line subject, antenna subject, radar or satellite, kindly comment into the comment box. Okay, I will try to make a video for that topic and I will upload it soon. Thank you.